There's a new class of supernovae which have been found that are 100 times brighter than the normal supernovae that we've known for the last 60 or 70 years. At the time that I was awarded the grant, there weren't very many known. Their physical origins weren't well understood. They were effectively unexplained. So when stars more massive than about 10 times the mass of the Sun, when they reach the end of their lives, they've got a core which is made of iron, and that core can't support the star. They can't produce any more energy to hold themselves up, and the core collapses. And that releases a huge amount of energy, and that effectively explodes the whole star. In a massive star, when the core collapses, it collapses down to a neutron star, and that is the densest form of matter we know. The material around the core falls onto it as well. The neutron star is incompressible, and there's a rebound and a bounce off the neutron star. So we study these stars, we try and work out which stars will produce supernovae, which stars will explode, which ones might produce neutron stars when they die, and which ones might produce black holes. And the reason this is important is that these supernovae have produced the chemical elements that we see on Earth and in the galaxy, and the critical chemical elements for life. So to study supernovae, we're not going to find many in our galaxy. So we have to search large volumes of the universe. So the idea of modern searches is to look at thousands of these galaxies, perhaps tens of thousands of these galaxies, to see if we can find new supernovae in them. What we do is we take large telescopes on Earth, we search large areas of the sky, so we're looking at large volumes of the universe, and we find exploding stars, and that's our speciality. For example, over the last year, we found about 3,000 supernovae, so we're the world-leading project for finding supernovae in the universe. So one key part of this project has been a telescope called the Pan-STARRS Telescope in Hawaii. The key thing about this telescope, it's got the biggest camera that's ever been built for civilian use. So it's 1.4 gigapixels. So what we've had to do here to do this project is to analyze the data stream from Hawaii, and this has turned into a big data project, basically. In Hawaii, the telescope, the Pan-STARRS Telescope, produces a terabyte of data per day. We download the data here, we put it on our machines. Previously, people used to take small images of the sky, you could analyze them on your own computer, but since the invention of these very large cameras, we've had to come up with new ways to process the data. And with the Pan-STARRS project, we've built up a reference image of the sky, so every time we now take a new image, we take our new image, we take the reference image, and we subtract the reference image from the new image, and that leaves anything that is left is something which is either a defect on the detector or it's something new in the sky. Popular development over the last few years is something called machine learning, which is trying to teach computers to think much more like humans. So we've developed techniques to look at the data, to work out which objects are real, which are not real, to search through those efficiently and to have a computer do it rather than humans look at every single object that comes out of this data project. We've trained these computers in a way that we think might be applicable to other areas. So for example, we're exploring with some of our medical colleagues, could some of these image recognition tools that we have be applied in the medical field to diagnose scans and diagnose them automatically and look for unusual features? What this grant has done, it's allowed us to be really the world leading, or one of the world leading groups in the study of these superluminous supernovae. We found many new superluminous supernovae and we studied them in detail. At the time they were discovered, about 5 or 6 years ago, there were many theories about what produced them. So we think the best idea now is that they're produced when a massive star collapses, produces a neutron star, but that neutron star is rapidly rotating and it's got a very large magnetic field. We think that this idea of a magnetic neutron star could explain most or nearly all of these superluminous supernovae that we see. The data we've collected and the analysis that we've done, I think shows that that is the leading model to produce these. And I think we've made a major impact in understanding them and studying them throughout the universe.